Fashion Dolls. It is Transformation Tuesday, April 4th, and welcome to another episode of Style by Stevie. Let's talk style today with stylist all the way from South Africa, Landani Styling. He is a celebrity stylist from the South Africa continent, and I'm super excited to have him here exclusively in the dollhouse. So let's welcome him all the way from South Africa, ladies and gentlemen, Landani Styling.
Hello, darling.
How are you, my love? Welcome to the dollhouse.
I'm fabulous. It's evening for us in South Africa. It's 10 p.m., so it's evening for us. I think it's afternoon for you guys.
Yes, it's 4:02 p.m. PST down here. Welcome to the dollhouse.
So, thank you so much for having me. I've been looking forward to today, hey?
Yes. We are going to get into fashion. You are a stylist. You are a celebrity stylist in the South Africa area. So we're going to be getting into some things today. So how has the year been for you thus far? How has 2023 been for you thus far?
The journey of styling and designing has been amazing. I've been doing it for 12 years. I went to fashion school. After fashion school, I did wardrobe for Soapies, Generation, Dizzy Dingo. And then I worked for magazines, which is completely different to styling on TV. And then I went solo, began my own clothing label and styling. And I've never looked back. So I now do styling and designing at the same time.
Okay. So what are some of your favorite designers? Because I know you have so many, and I've looked at your Instagram and I am very impressed. Like, your styling is on point. The photographies, the visual are absolutely beautiful. So for you, where do you get the inspiration for your fashions from? Because I know you pull from so many different eras of fashion out here. So where do you pull the inspiration for your looks from?
So my signature is black and white. I love black and white. It's timeless. Oh. It's never out of fashion. So anything including black and white for me works. So whether I'm making an evening gown or designing a men's suit or a men's jacket, if there's black and white, it's my favorite. I take so much of inspiration from 60s fashion. I love 60s fashion. And also a bit of the 80s hippie fashion I also love and incorporate. But I like clean lines. I like simple but classic, you know, stuff that will always be in fashion, not stuff that's relevant now. I'm big on style more than fashion because there's a huge difference between style and fashion. Fashion we wear now, fashion we see now, but style lives forever.
Absolutely, and it's timeless. Who are some of your style influences? Because I know you have so many. You're in South Africa, so who are some of your favorite South Africa style influencers, as well as some down here in the U.S.?
So we have something called the SA Style Awards, which we have every year. We basically just give awards to the most stylish people, stylish females, stylish males, stylish designers, stylish influencers. And then we have things like horse racing events like the Durban July, which is very big on fashion. It's an outdoor event. I don't know what you guys call it overseas, but we call it Durban July. It's like a horse racing event, like a polo basically, where there's horse racing and people just dress up in hats and fascinators and long gowns. That's our big fashion moment in South Africa. And then of course we have our red carpet moments, like our awards. Like we have Soapy Awards, we have music awards, we have all types of awards.
Okay. And it's award season down here in the USA. I know you've seen the CMT Awards, Country Music Awards, and we have the Billboard Awards, like so many down here in the US. Who are some of your favorite artists? Like, who are some of your favorite musical artists, and what fashions do you like on them?
Musicians that I love internationally?
Yes.
Let me speak of two, and they're very different. I love Beyonce, the way she dresses.
My girl.
Because she can be very sexy, you know, showing off legs, showing off, you know, some sexiness, and can pull off a ga- now on the next day for red carpet event. I think Beyonce's ability to just be sexy and be one for stage and then switch and just be very formal and be like a queen and just be like a wife to Jay-Z on the red carpet for me is amazing. And then funny enough, my other style icon has to be Adele and Pharrell. They're very different. So Pharrell, of course, you know, is now the creative director for Louis Vuitton. His style has always been iconic, always different, always just breaking boundaries. I love Pharrell's style, Pharrell Williams. And then Adele, I love how she's such a lady, will always be wearing a gown, you know, a touch of pearls. So ladylike, it just looks like her music. I always say the way she styles looks like her music. So for me, those are my style icons internationally.
And it's a classic. It goes back to what you're saying about classic. Like what we're both dressed in today is very classy, very elegant. And I believe that fashion should be carried with attitude. And you've mentioned Beyonce. She's one of my fashion influences as well, too. And it's so subtle. Like she teamed up with Balmain to do her couture collection. Absolutely. I'm pretty sure you've seen it. Absolutely. What are your thoughts on the collection thus far? Because she has so many pieces.
It's quite amazing. Even the styling for her latest album, Renaissance, absolutely epic. I don't think Beyonce has ever disappointed us style-wise. I just think she keeps it elevating. I mean, Renaissance, the album, like the Vogue cover she did, leading to the release of the album, the styling was... Can she ever? Like, that's amazing for me. Her partnership with... I know she just ended her partnership now with Adidas. You know, the Ivy Park was also amazing. It was like more for casual stuff, but it was still sexy. It still gave Beyonce, you know? And then now she's working with Balmain, which is amazing. You know, I think she keeps on elevating herself. I think she never gets it wrong. Like, Beyonce is a queen. I'm sorry to say, she's a queen.
Absolutely. And I'm pretty sure you've seen her Dubai performance when she came out on stage and the costumes.
And the water.
Absolutely beautiful.
I see the costume.
Yes.
The random water just matching the costumes. I'm like, girl, give us a break.
She's always, like you said, elevating with fashion because the eras changed so much. You mentioned the 60s and the 80s, and there's so many fashion icons from the 80s. Who are some of your favorite fashion icons from the 80s? I love Grace Jones. I am a big Grace Jones fanatic, and the way Grace carries herself with such drama and attitude. And she's unapologetic about who she is. And that's why I love Grace Jones. So who are some of your favorite style icons from the 80s?
From the 80s, I would definitely say Diana Ross and Whitney. Musically, you know, if you look at the life of Whitney, you know, she always, for me, I feel like Beyonce looks up to Whitney in a way. Whitney served voice, served performance, but only served looks. I also loved Diana Ross's fashion. Her daughter, Tracy, is also taking a bit of that. If you watch her fashion, she's taking from the mom, you know, which is quite beautiful to watch how she's the younger version, but still taking elements from the mom. I think Michael Jackson also has his moments. You know, there are outfits when you wear them, they're like, you are giving Michael Jackson. I think Michael Jackson got the whole shiny, the bling, the sequence is definitely Michael Jackson's 80s fashion iconic moment that we, even as designers, take from in terms of styling. His denim jackets that were cropped, but were very well designed and well structured. You know, so Michael Jackson, Diana Ross, and Whitney.
So, with the current, with us now being in springtime and now coming from the cold, what fashion trends are you looking forward to for the spring season? Because I viewed your Instagram and it's beautiful. The pieces that you dressed up on the models are everything. So what colors and prints and patterns are you looking forward to for the spring month?
So can I tell you a funny story? So you guys go into spring before us. So we swap seasons. So now we are in April, we're in autumn. and we'll be in winter soon. And then you guys just left winter, going to spring. And I know this because 2 weeks ago, I had some guests from Atlanta and the US who came to South Africa and bought some stuff from me. And they were asking me the same question. So what should we look forward to? What's going to be in fashion for the next spring, upcoming spring, summer? Funny enough, my colors, black and white, are coming back full force. Black and white is going to be fashion. Can you believe it? And I do black and white as a passion. It turns out now that black and white is going to be taking over fashion-wise. Denim never leaves the fashion calendar. Denim is always reinvented. Like,
at all.
There's always new ways of reinventing denim. So denim will still be a thing, I know for sure. And I like the fact that we are using a lot of prints, you know, internationally. So in Africa and across the board, print type big thing. Even now I'm wearing tribal prints. So prints and mosaic prints, you know, these artifacty prints are going into fashion, you know. Last year we saw a lot of the face prints, you know, the woman with the half face was a big thing. That began in Korea, moved to the US and came to South Africa. You know, the whole silhouette of the woman's face was a big thing. We called it African. Now we're crossing over where we're going more geometric with our prints. So geometric prints are going to be a vibe. And lots of color. I don't think we can, you know, ever get tired of color. I think the beauty of spring is that we can wear color, you know. And what happens, we start off soft with the pastels, and then we go stronger with the solids in summer. Another color that never, ever gets outdated is nude, shades of nude. So your taupes, your khakis, your browns, in summer, in autumn, in winter, always safe to wear because you can always put color on top of that as your base.
And yes, you mentioned pastel colors. It's funny because I'm wearing lilac today. Lilac is a perfect spring color, along with lime green. I love lime green and blue and yellow. It's so many. And when we put it on our skin tones, it comes to life. It is beautiful. And I've seen so many gowns this season in this particular color, as well as like a lime green color. I think of Beyonce. You mentioned Beyonce at the Oscars. And she wore this yellow with the gloves.
The cape dress, I remember, yes.
Yeah. Absolutely beautiful. And her performance, she wore like a lime green color. So those colors are going to be popular for the springtime as well, too. A lot of pantsuits. Now, dresses, do you prefer gowns, dresses? Because I see you do a little bit of everything with your models on your page in your designs, and your designs are gorgeous. Please follow Lindani Styling in South Africa. And I'm all the way in the USA, and I've seen it, and I was like, I had to do a double take because I am obsessed with, I am a couture fashion girl. I love couture fashion. Anything that flows, or when I walk into a room, it just flows right along with me and it comes to life. And I put it on because I love my gowns and I love my sundresses, especially for like the springtime season. And my rompers, of course, too. But for you on your models, do you let them have an input as well, too, on the look as well?
You know, speaking of gowns, let's start there. Speaking of gowns, I'm a big fan of maxis. Like, I think if you can dress up a maxi, add a bit of bling, add a bit of detail, that for me makes you a style icon, because anybody can just wear an evening dress that has beads. That's so basic for me. But for me, like if you look at the Met Gala, like your Zendaya, I'm trying to think. One of the artists also did that. They did like a maxi gown for the Met Gala, and it looked amazing.
Uh-oh, we lost Lindani. Thank you guys for coming in. Welcome to the Dollhouse, Fashion Dolls. We are talking spring fashion trends with Lindani Styling all the way in South Africa. I'm in the USA, and I'm loving this conversation. You guys know that I am a fashion girl. And if you follow me here on Instagram, you know that I'm always posting inspiration from different eras of fashion. So definitely, again, please follow Lindani Styling. We are talking spring fashion trends. Now, you said maxi dresses. My mom is a maxi dress, sundress type of girl, and I've kind of gotten her into wearing rompers and stuff as well, too. She loves rompers. So it's all about versatility for spring fashion season. Now, for men's fashion, what can you expect for men's fashion? Because I don't want to exclude my male audience. I know they're just like, well, all she talks about is women's fashion. But the male audience, what can you expect for the men for this season for spring fashion? You've mentioned Pharrell, and Pharrell is a style icon. I love him.
Two things for men. Men are definitely becoming more brave. Men are not scared to wear color, firstly. So yes, we are looking forward to seeing men wearing colorful suits. So you mentioned you love lilac lavender, baby blue, shades of green suits for men, printed suits for men. Even things like where the jacket is plain but the pants is printed. And then the men have fun because they can do double-breasted, they can do tuxedo cards, they can do a blazer, t-shirt, and a printed pant, so they can have fun. But men are becoming more bold. They're not scared to wear color, not scared to wear print, which I think is amazing to see. And moving into spring now, men are going to have fun, even just with shirts, like beautiful, bright shirts. Maybe the suit is solid, but the shirt is floral, or just a strong shirt and pants. You know, I don't think dressing up should just be a suit. I think a strong shirt and a good tailored pants can go a long way.
Absolutely. And I like Michael Strahan. I'm pretty sure you're familiar with Michael Strahan. He wears a lot of colors, and he takes risks with the style as well, too, as well as LeBron James and so many others. Like, they're stepping up the style game, and you're starting to see a lot more men wear color in their wardrobe. And I think it's hot because the months are going to be hot, and it's time, like, when the fall, winter months come, the colors get darker. When it's, like you said, the spring months, you get into your pastels and your brighter colors. It's sort of like an unveiling for me. And I can't go a day without adding color into my wardrobe because it definitely enhances your mood when you put on a nice outfit. Now, we just recently came from off the runway from Paris Fashion Week and New York Fashion Week and so long. Who are some of your favorite go-to designers? Because when you've mentioned men's suits, I thought of Roberto Cavalli. Their menswear collection had a lot of animal print and they added color. So who are some of your favorite designers that you've seen for Paris and New York fashion?
I'll mention two. So Louis Vuitton has this new thing where men are wearing skirts. Jaden Smith has been wearing a lot of LV. I don't know if you've seen recently. So he's been even caught off camera rocking a skirt or rocking like a two-piece crop jacket and hipster pants, very much from the 80s fashion. So I think Louis Vuitton is definitely breaking the norm with their men's fashion. They're going hectically. And I think with the addition of Pharrell Williams, they're going to just elevate. Dolce & Gabbana has this thing about clash prints, which I think I'm obsessed. There'll be leopard prints and floral and tribal in one fabric. And they use this beautiful pure silk, pure chiffon, pure georgette fabrics. So definitely Dolce & Gabbana and Louis Vuitton are doing it for me. I'm also a big fan of Armani. So yeah, those designers are doing a lot, hey. Who's this also? I just saw, but this was from last year. Who was it? Oscar De La Renta. Their collection last year was, you know.
I like you. Yes. You've mentioned Oscar De La Renta, and I read a lot of Vogue. We'll get to that, some of your favorite fashion magazines, because I'm on fashion. I like to go back in time and look at the archives and see what different designers. Terry Mugler is one of my favorite designers as well, too, and he's known for his outrageous designs, and he makes them, when the models wear them on the runway, they come to life. They tell a story. So it's sort of like they come from out of space, and he does this thing with insects. So Terry Mugler is one of my favorite designers personally. But you've mentioned, back to Oscar De La Renta. Oscar De La Renta, if you go back, I want to say 1987, a lot of those styles, because you've mentioned the 80s, are coming back in time. And I'm just like, wow, it's so funny that history is now repeating itself. And
it's a cycle, yes.
Yes. Another one is Saint Laurent. I'm pretty sure you've seen their collection with the over-exaggerated shoulders, which was a thing of the 80s.
Definitely. And also, is it wise? I'm just trying to think. For New York Fashion Week, I saw one of the designers. There's this new trend of wearing a coat as a dress, but you wear it reversed. Have you seen that? Who's that?
Oh my goodness. I don't know. Christian Siriano.
Or Dior, but I saw it. Somebody sent me a picture where you take a jacket, you wear it reversed, and you use the sleeves to be a belt, and you basically, the collar is like the corset part of it. There's a new trend that's happening, and it's so amazing to see, you know. But I've been following Oscar De La Renta for a while. I'm also obsessed with their fashion. I'm obsessed with what they do on the men versus the women, because with the ladies, it's the colors, it's the florals, it's the maxis, but on the guys, it's strong prints and very 80s hippie style, which is so amazing to see.
And it's so beautiful watching them come down the runway as they come to life. Another one of my favorite designers is Sergio Hudson. And I know you follow him. You will fall in love with his designs. Like, they're definitely, his designs are inspired by the 90s and a little bit of the 80s with the tailored suits for women, with the dresses and everything. He'll pair a blazer and a skirt together. Like, he's so creative. So I know if you love Dolce & Gabbana, you will love Sergio Hudson. And his design, how he brings them to life. All of these designers have a vision. Now for you, where do you, oh, he froze on us, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome if you're just coming in. We are here with Lindani Styling, and we are talking spring fashion trends, or what I like to call spring fashion revival. And it's so amazing that we are now coming from out of the fall and winter months, now unveiling a new layer of what is to be spring, summer fashions. So I'm happy to be having this conversation. I'm going to add Lindani Styling back. Lindani, if you're ready, you let me know and I will add you back. I think he dropped, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Steph. Hey, Nail Gigi. Thank you. Hey, girl. I miss you, sis. How are you doing? And this is the dress that I'm wearing today, you guys, as you can see. I got a little stomach out today. Something very light and carefree. Special thanks to Melody Nalama Bridges on makeup for always getting me right each and every episode. I hope you guys are enjoying the conversation in here. Let me see if Lindani is back so that I can add him back. Nope, not yet. Make sure you guys follow each other. I hope you guys enjoyed the conversation. Hopefully we can bring Lindani back. I'm going to stay on a little bit longer. Yes, we are talking spring fashion revival. You guys know that we are now in spring months of fashion, and I'm super excited because so many things have evolved throughout the years. Thank you, Nail GT. Thank you, girl. And definitely, I've seen some of Nail Gigi's artwork, so y'all, please go and check her out. She was dope. Please go and follow my girl, Nail Gigi, and my girl, Steph. Definitely go and follow them. Thank you. Thank y'all. Y'all like the lilac? It's like any color I put on, it comes to life. And I think that fashion should breathe an expectation. Whenever you put something on, you bring it to life because it's your piece. You don't wear, the clothes don't wear you. You wear the clothes. And I wanted something very carefree and lightweight today. You can see it's like a dress shirt at the top and then it's a get down to the bottom. You can see the cutouts right there. So I wanted to do something a little different today because yesterday, what did I wear yesterday? I forgot what I wore. I wore a beautiful sundress from Fashionista, and you guys can follow her here right here on Instagram. She is Black owned. Nail Gigi is Black owned. And I'm all about supporting Black owned businesses here on my platform, women of color in general. So thank you for my new viewers for tuning in and watching the platform. I appreciate the love so much. Let me see if Lindani Styling is back so that I can add him back. Nope, not yet. I think his phone might have died. But if not, then we can reschedule. But wrap it up a little bit. We were talking spring fashion revival. What am I looking forward to the spring? I'm looking forward to some gowns, some sundresses. Girl, I'm telling you, for my ladies out here who are watching this, add a pop of color to your wardrobe. You can never go wrong. I was going to do red today. actually. I seen this beautiful red gown, and it was cold shoulder, and I was going to wear it today on the platform. But I said, it's too hot to be doing all of that. I'll probably be doing it during the winter months. So I decided to do something very carefree, very lightweight. My back is literally out in this dress. So I'm going to turn. There you go. There you go. I'm in shape and everything. So I said, if I'm going to put on something, I got to represent for my curvy girls because I'm 5'7". All right, Lindani Styling is back, ladies and gentlemen. And we are talking my favorite thing, fashion. So I'm super excited. And it's a win-win. Thank you. Yes, that's the back. The back is out and everything today. And we are back.
My phone decided to reboot itself. Can you believe?
We are back, love. It was great to have you back in here. Don't worry, I got you covered. I held it on. I held it down for you. We were talking about Oscar de la Renta. That's who we were on. Another one of my favorites is Christian Dior. You mentioned Christian Dior. If you go back in time, let's say 1988, 1987.
And I was born in 88, by the way, so hello.
We see each other. We understand. Yes, the gowns are gorgeous. Yes, and please tell me you've seen the gowns and how they had the drape like this taffeta around them. It was beautiful. So
it's so funny, the fabric they used to use back then. We used to love in South Africa. We used to love if you wore anything called the taffeta fabric. It's like, oh my god, it's giving grandma, it's giving aunties. But taffeta is coming back. Beyonce wore a yellow taffeta gown for one of the awards. That yellow cape dress she wore is taffeta fabric. Hello, you know.
See?
So fashion is a way of just always reinventing itself. It's so interesting.
And again, it goes back to what you were saying about history repeating itself for fashion, because the styles are coming back. And a lot of these styles, you'd be like, wait, oh my God, we used to wear that back in the 80s and we would wear that back in the 90s. And to see them come back and revive, it's just like, it's timeless. And it goes back to what you said in the beginning of the interview, which is look forward to timeless fashions. I look to fashions that make a timeless staple. So that's why you see a lot of stars like Cardi B. And you've mentioned Zendaya. Zendaya wore a vintage piece. And Meg Thee Stallion also just recently wore a vintage piece. You're seeing a lot of fashions come to life from these models and these artists. Yes.
Yeah, Kim did the same thing. Which event was it when Kim wore the Marilyn Monroe dress? I think she trended. I think it was framed or kept at some fashion museum.
Give it a minute. Welcome as you're coming in for my new fashion dolls. Welcome to the dollhouse. We are here with Lindani Styling, and we are talking fashion, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, the zipper and then one of the diamonds came off the gown. That gown was expensive. Yes, and when you're digging in the archives, when you're digging in the archives for these vintage fashion pieces, like, for example, I'll give you an example. Cardi B. Let me see if I can pull that photo up of Cardi B and Mugler. She wore Mugler at the Grammy Awards. And if you guys don't know which piece I'm talking about, I'm going to find it up for you guys right now. It's so amazing. She wore a lot of vintage pieces from Mugler at the Grammys. Here's the first one. Yes, where she wore the pearl detailing and everything. Absolutely gorgeous. Another one of my favorites is this one right here. And model Eva Hart Zagova wore that gown. That is vintage Terry Mugler. That is who I was talking about, if you guys are not familiar with Mugler. Because a lot of his designs, when the models would walk out, they would be like so detailed. He would pull inspiration from insects like butterflies and caterpillars. And then her Grammys performance. This is what she wore. That is Mugler also as well, too. And the model was kind of like doing this little flamingo type dance. Y'all know what I'm trying to do. She was doing a dance when she wore the gown originally. So Cardi had it down pat. And the pieces went right back to the museum, the fashion museum. So they have to basically take this thing where it's like it's in this bag and they kind of have to air. Yeah. So if you're going to wear a vintage piece, you have to be very careful with vintage fashion pieces. Because as my girl Steph said, when Kim Kardashian wore that gown to the Met Gala, it was the Met Gala, the stone came off the gown, and then I think it was the zipper detailing busted on the back. Yes. A lot of people were upset with Kim for that. So, I mean, if I was that small, because I have pictures of Marilyn on my wall, she's actually one of my style influences, and I could not fit into a gown like that. I'm a little bit more on the curvy side. So, but the gown was gorgeous, though. That's the gown she wore when she sung Happy Birthday to President Kennedy. So, yeah, vintage. Vintage is in. And here's a little bit more of Terry McGlare's designs, if you guys are not familiar. That's Linda Evangelista. And Marilyn Monroe was tiny. Marilyn Monroe was tiny. And I couldn't wear anything like that. It's absolutely stunning on Marilyn, but I couldn't wear anything like that. But it's beautiful, though. Okay, we were talking about Mugler. Cardi B and Mugler. Again, the love affair continues. Focus, focus, focus. All right, fashion dolls. But yes, I love how the seamstresses and the stylists are going in and finding things to alter the body type of these artists out here. Because fashion comes in so many shapes and sizes. And designers, I'm thankful for Christian Siriano and so many others. That Zach Posen is another one that are being size inclusive to all of their sizes, to women of all sizes, because we're not all shaped the same. You know what I'm saying? I don't have to say I'm about an hourglass figure. I'm all on a 5'7" girl. I'm an hourglass, like an hourglass figure. So it's amazing that designers are being size inclusive. Now Mugler is size inclusive as well, too. I mean, you only see one curvy model that will be able to fit into his designs, but you're seeing a lot more designers. Sergio Hudson, that's why I mentioned him, because he's size inclusive as well, too. And a lot of designers are now taking a cue from, like, let's say, I mentioned Christian Siriano and so many others, and being size inclusive for models and just people in real time and real time. Yep. All right, fashion dolls, let me see if Len Donnie is back so that I can add him. I hope you guys enjoyed the conversation thus far. Hopefully he will come back. Hi, Timothy. Welcome, welcome. Welcome to the dollhouse. As you come in, welcome, welcome. I hope you guys all are doing wonderful out there. Let me see if Lendani is back so that I can add him. All right, fashion dolls. If not, then I'm going to conclude and wrap up. Now, Thursday, joining me Thursday, we have from hit shows such as Scandal, he's going to be joining me here in the dollhouse. Thomas Bell will be joining me Thursday. So make sure you guys tune in for that. Y'all know about Olivia Pope, Kerry Washington. Yes, he is going to be here Thursday. Definitely. He's also from the hit show Monogamy as well, too. So make sure you guys tune in Thursday for that. There will be no show tomorrow, but we'll be back Thursday. And before we go, before we wrap up, I'm going to give you guys the final thought of the day, which comes from Diana Ross. You can't just sit there and wait for people to give you that golden dream. You've got to get out there and make it happen for yourself. And I put this quote on my vision board because if you or me, you believe that anything is possible. Anything is possible. And I've created this platform all by myself. I started at a very young age with Style by Stevie. And when I first started, my girl Stephanie can attest to that. I started off doing it at, 2016, 2018. So I've been doing it for a long time. We're now in season 17. We started season 17 back in, I want to say, January of this year, 2023. Started January 2nd. Take that. Absolutely. Absolutely nailed you, G. Taking a leap can be scary for some of us. And I touched on this yesterday in yesterday's show that we had. We we touched on that with Stephen Voice. And it was so amazing because sometimes taking career opportunities and jumping and taking a leap of faith can be risk-taking. And a lot of people are just used to being in their norm, in their comfort zone. And trust me, I know it all too well. I'm so used to being in my comfort zone. But now I'm just like, do it. Take that leap of faith. Don't be afraid. Sometimes it can be scary. Restarting can be scary. But I love starting over. And I say this all the time. It is like a rebirthing process. It's like a rebirthing process because you're true to who you are, and originality is key. We talked a lot about individuality and originality on yesterday's show with Stephen Voice. So it's amazing how far you can go in your life if you just sit back and don't wait for people to give you that golden dream. You got to wait for it. You got to wait. Opportunity comes to you, and I sit and I built this opportunity and this platform for myself, and I'm thankful to be where I'm at in my life with Style by Stevie to see how far. Today, Style by Stevie has increased. I thank you guys so much for your love and your support unconditionally. You guys are awesome fashion dolls, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you guys viewing the platform every day, watching the platform, and supporting. Just going back and watching the replays and some of the things. I don't ask for much. You guys go back and do it for me. You watch the replays, you check out the interviews, and I'm starting to receive all of this love, and I am receiving all of the abundance. Thank you guys so much for that. I truly am thankful, 100%. I'm glad you enjoyed it, NeoGG. Thank you, Timothy. I'm glad you guys all enjoyed today's show. We talked about fashion in different eras, different decades, in case you guys missed it, with Mandani Styling. And I had such a great time. You guys can see my face light up throughout the whole conversation because I am a fashion girl. I eat, sleep, and breathe fashion. And I'm always evolving and changing my look. I don't stay the same. I don't stay the same. And I feel that we should all reinvent ourselves, not just on the outside, but the inside as well, too. If you want to change, change for the better. And there's nothing wrong with starting over and beginning again anew. Trust me, I've had to learn the hard way. And I talked to my girl Stephanie and Alan Yankee about that, about the process of starting over and how difficult it was for me. I was devastated when I had to start over this platform and everything. And it's just like, wow. But to see the response and the outpouring love for people, knowing they understand where I come from, where it's like a rebirthing process, it's amazing. And you guys are awesome. So I'm glad you guys enjoyed today's show. I'm going to wrap it up here, Fashion Dolls. And that concludes today's show. We will be back Thursday with Thomas Bell. So make sure you guys tune in at 4 p.m. for that. Set your reminders and tune in to Style by Stevie. And head on over and subscribe to Style by Stevie Daytime on YouTube as well, too. You can check out some of the previous shows in case you've missed any. I love you all, Fashion Dolls, and we will see you guys tomorrow. I was about to say tomorrow, but Thursday. You guys take care.